Good afternoon, welcome to another episode of Mikey Makes.
I've just turned my tumble dryer off so you can do this.
This afternoon I'm going to be making beef en croute.
Got to iron it later.
Not the beef or not. Anyway, the ingredients are...
Look at that!
Nice piece of beef fillet. Some red wine. A couple of pancakes that I've already made.
To wrap round your meat.
And that's actually James Martin's fault, because I spoke to him this morning and I said, James, got this issue. I normally do it with parma ham, what do you reckon? And he said, no, me old mucker, you ought to use pancakes. So we've got pancakes and we're going to try it his way. Already prepared also are a load of chestnut mushrooms and porcini mushrooms and portobello mushrooms and a load of wild mushrooms that we went out and picked this morning that were finely chopped. And in there we've got a number of shallots that have been finely chopped as well.
My arse, did we?
And just to save a little bit of time, we've got shop-bought...
Puff
pastry.
Sorry, puff.
I've already proved that I can make it, and I suppose if you wanted to make it, you could make it yourself.
Why would you?
But we're not going to.
Can you just say where you got your meat from? Because that is a particularly good local shop, isn't it?
I got that from the local butcher's...
Good Life.
Farm shop in Kingsworthy in the garden centre there.
Lush.
Anyway, so without any more to do, any more messing about, what we're going to do is sear the beef. So I've got a pan, which was kind of preheated. A little bit of... virgin olive oil, and I'm going to sear it all over. We'll come back when that's done, because apparently it doesn't appear to be quite as hot as I thought it was. So we'll come back in a minute.
Story your life, that, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Right, so we have sealed the beef. We're going to set that aside for a little while. In the big pan, I have melted a bit of butter and added olive oil. And now what I'm going to do is throw all the mushrooms and the onion. I'll shut it. All the mushrooms and the onions into the pan, and we're going to give them a bit of a cook. So if you come back in a few minutes' time, I'll show you what it looks like.
Here we go. Do you want me to come and have a look?
Yep. In the pan, I've also put some thyme.
That's as far as I'm going to go, and I'm zeroing.
And some Idle Bastard's garlic paste.
It's called lazy garlic, and the thyme... You can use a sprig of fresh, but you can only buy a ton of thyme. You can't buy a sprig. Now, what's this mushroom mixture, Jonesy?
It's three or four different mushrooms, a few shallots, all chopped up very sharp and finely, and it's being reduced. And the idea is to get it nice and dry as we possibly can. We're also going to add a slug of red wine.
How long does it take to do?
Oh, about
all right.
10 minutes or so. So you could probably.
And what's it called?
Ducelle.
Yes, that's what I was getting at, rather than a life story.
If you're from Yorkshire,
Duxall.
It's Duxalls, which is apparently what my mate James was calling it this morning. Did I tell you I spoke to James?
Oh, shut up! I'm going back to my lapsang souchong. Oh dear.
And in about 10 or 15 minutes' time, we'll come back, and they should be nice, dry, and breadcrumby in consistency. It smells wonderful. Just so that you can see what it looks like, we're going to show you the mushrooms and the onions and all the rest of it after it's been bubbling away for about 10 minutes. It's actually nowhere near dry enough yet, so it's going to need to go a little bit longer. But it's looks a lot like that. Anyway, we'll come back in a few minutes' time. Hopefully, it'll be drier still.
Right. I can't go too far.
Don't be tempted to take it out too early. It needs to be really, really dry. Believe it or not, this has been going for about 20-odd minutes. But it's still not dry enough. But I just want to show you that even at that stage...
I don't know if you can tell, to be quite honest. I mean, it's there, but it's so finely minced.
But you've got to keep moving it because we don't want it to burn. So we'll come back in a couple of minutes' time.
All right, I'm going to sit bang in the toilet.
Okay.
Go.
That is the mushrooms now reduced. Can you see that?
Yeah, actually, yeah.
I'm going to take them out of the pan because I don't want them burning when I... don't want to burn me either. So that's the mushrooms. And now I'll get ready to roll the pastry. So come back in a few seconds' time, a few minutes' time, and we'll be doing the pastry. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That's the puff pastry rolled out, and it is that shape deliberately. And then I'm using a couple of pancakes. Crepe, I suppose, if you're in France, which we're not.
They're not that bad.
Then I'm going to take my mushrooms.
Do you need both crepes?
I need, actually, a little bit of chicken liver pate. Forgot the chicken liver pate. We're not going to put too much on, because it can be a little bit overpowering, but we're just going to put a little bit on. Apart from anything else, it'll help things stick. That's right, this is one that we made earlier. And then we put it into a pot.
Marked Sainsbury's.
Tesco's, I think.
Every little house. We won't need that much.
Really. Other supermarkets are available. So, just putting a little bit of pate, which doesn't want to know, actually.
All right, we'll come back while you're masticating that.
Okay.
Go.
I'm just putting finishing touches to spreading out the chicken liver pate. I'm not putting very much on there. Then I'm putting on the mushrooms.
Gone dark, haven't they?
Yeah, because they're burnt.
No, they're not burnt. Give us a little bit. There's my hand in there. Let me try a little bit.
That's the executive producer stealing some. Oh. And then put the beef on.
Bloody hell.
And the difficulty now is going to be making it look pretty. But we'll give it a go.
What about turning the beef the other way, so you've got the... Actually, no, I think they'll be all right. If...
Those pancakes are almost exactly the right size.
Might need a lot of editing this.
Tell you what, give me a couple of minutes, let me just cut these loose bits off.
Alright.
And we'll come back.
Alright. I'm zooming.
And here's the finished article. And since it's Christmas, nearly, what I've done is I've cut out little holly leaves and little holly balls and I've stuck them all over it. And the fact that it covers the dog ugly join...
It is ugly.
...just a happy coincidence. Now, in my defence, the fact that it's a funny shape has got more to do with the shape of the cow than anything else, because I can't do very much with it.
You having a pop?
No. But there you go. Now, unusually...
Actually, they imagine that golden brown...
Well, I'll take a photograph tomorrow, because this is actually part of a Meals on Wheels deal. My mother has got a cripple sticker, and she said we can borrow it to go to Lakeland shopping tomorrow
figure.
If we feed her. So we're taking this down tomorrow. So we're not, the oven's not on, we're not cooking at the moment, but we'll give it an egg wash tomorrow. And we'll put up, you see a picture of it when it's finished in all its glory. Those little bits, by the way,
not mouse shit.
Are the Ducelle mushrooms, or if you come from Yorkshire, the Duxels.
And can I just say, the correct word is disability parking permit, not cripple sticker, just for those that might get offended.
Yes, yeah, sorry, none intended. So there you go, proving that any idiot can do a... Beef Wellington.
Yeah, can any idiot tidy up the kitchen?
Yeah, if you want.
Humour. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Right.
Right, so there we go. That's the finished article. It's been in the oven for how long?
40 minutes.
40 minutes. We'll let it stand for a little while and show you when we open it.
This is Mike in his mum's kitchen. And that's his mum. That's Mike.
You don't want Bisto in it.
Product placement. That's product placement. So that is the beef Wellington, which in our part of the world we call a posh pastie.
Pastie. That's it. Right, Jonesy?
Okay.
So...
I don't want the back of your head, do I?
There you go. There's the baby. How's that?
That's good. I would give your mum the...
That bit?
Yeah, but I might flash it.
in the microwave.
Yeah.
Are you all right with it as it is?